This video is brought to you by Envato.
If you've been seeing a lot of gritty posters that look like they've been printed in the 70s, thrown up on a street pole, and left out in the sun, same. This dusty, collage-heavy, vintage Western aesthetic is having a moment right now, and I'm here for it. I want to break down what makes this style work, and then I'll show you how to recreate your own using Photoshop. But first, what is this style really? It's giving rodeo flyer meets punk zine with a theatrical edge. You'll see chunky serif fonts, grimy textures, chaotic cutouts, bold reds and beiges, and just the right amount of rodeo flair. It of course pulls inspiration from old rodeo posters, but also Chitlin Circus Show flyers and some faded Americana. Designers today are blending that nostalgia with pop culture. I mean, have you seen the artwork for Beyoncé's Cowboy Carter tour? Let's see if we can make our own. Okay, so I am sitting in front of my computer and I am going to go ahead and open up Photoshop so we can design our poster for what I decided will be a theater show titled Midnight Rodeo. This theater show is going to 3 cities. We're going on tour, 3 nights only, and we need some posters to advertise this thing. So to set up our document, I am going with 11x17 for our poster, and of course we have to be set up for print. So we will be using CMYK at 300 PPI. Now, the very first thing I want to do is prepare my assets. Even if I am not 100% sure of what it is that I want this to look like, I have an idea of the aesthetic. And so I do want to go and source some elements that might be included in this poster. These will be things like your photos, your textures, your fonts, and so on. We do know the characteristics of the look and feel that we're trying to create here. So while you're sourcing, you do want to think of things like chunky serif fonts and bold colors, the basic shapes, grainy textures, you get it. So I chose to source some stock photos directly from Envato. Look at her. The photos kind of speak for themselves. I have also pulled a few typeface options. I did want to pull a range out of those characteristics, so some that were like a little more extreme on the Western side and some that were just like slab serifs that could fit potentially, or something that's a little more on the modern side. You get me, I want to have a small range. Not overboard, I picked about 5 fonts to choose from. I also pulled some textures, but we'll get to that towards the end. Whatever you think you need, prepare yourself to use it. So with this style, you're definitely bound to see some cutouts and collaging happening, of course. And so I'm gonna go ahead and take care of that here. I'm gonna remove the background on all of our main photos. I think those main photos include anything featuring this girl right here. We have these 3 photos. And removing the background is so simple now. You only need to click a button, which is crazy. You may need to make some adjustments, so I suggest zooming in and checking everything out, but do it in whatever step you see fit. Let's take care of the last 2. Great. And then this one here. I do also know overall that I want my poster's color palette to be mostly muted or like neutral beiges, blacks, things like that, but with pops of color. Red seems to be a requirement for the pops of color. That's just the way it goes with this style. So not only am I gonna go ahead and apply a color to our background, but I am also going to apply a color overlay to the main images that we just removed the backgrounds from. To do that, I'm going to add a layer style and go to color overlay. You can apply a black and white effect directly to the photos, but I prefer the color overlay just because it gives me a little more control in case I wanna change the hue later or something like that. We're going with the flow. So I'm going to go ahead and add an overlay that is the same color as our background. You can see it giving an aged effect, and that is what I want. So I'm going to copy the layer style and apply it to all 3 of my main photos. So let's open up all 3 at once, and I think it is clear that we need to arrange these into something, and so I definitely want to play with scale and depth. So I'm just going to arrange these and overlap them until they're in a place that I like. To play with the layering here, since removing the background adds a mask to the photo, I'm just going to adjust the already existing mask. So I'm actually gonna do it on this top image, the main image. We'll click on that mask, go to subtract from mask, and then adjust our brush and give her the illusion that she is in front of this hair. Okay, so here is where we landed with our first 3 photos. I would like to jump into playing with depth and dimension a little bit further. We know that basic shapes show up a lot in this style of graphic, and I'm thinking a sunburst in the middle behind this key art would look great because it'll draw attention to the center of the photo. It is a basic shape and it won't overpower the entire poster, so I'm gonna go for it. To do the sunburst in Photoshop, and let's make sure we can see, I'm gonna get rid of my girls, see you later. We're going to start with creating a basic gradient in the background. Your gradient tool is hidden behind your paint bucket tool. I lose it every day. Once in your gradient tool, go ahead and draw a line in the center from top to bottom. And if you scroll down in your properties, you'll see here where you can adjust your colors. So if you select either of these, you'll be able to choose the colors that you want. I suggest working with one lighter and one darker color. The darker color will be what makes the actual sunburst shape by the time we're done. So you want to be able to see it, of course. So I'm gonna go with this. And I do want to make sure the lighter color matches the background that we selected originally on our poster. You can also choose to select a gradient that is transparent on the other end. Just make sure that you have a dark color in there. Let's now convert that gradient layer to a smart object. And from here is where we can apply a couple of filters and effects to magically create this shape. I know it's a lot, but if you're in Photoshop making it from scratch, here you go. You can also source this element if you like. So in your filter menu, we're gonna go to distort and then wave. And not to bore you to death, but these are the values that give you single stripes across your canvas. You're gonna do about 700. We have 698 generators here. Your wavelength minimum is 120 with a 121 maximum, 1 to 999 amplitude, and your scale is going to be 100 to 100%. So now we have some nice crisp lines. Let's go ahead and apply our last filter in distort as well. That'll be polar coordinates. And as you can see, it's pretty much you just do rectangular to polar and it does it for you. You hit okay. And we're going to have this sit behind our photos. So let's show the key art again, and there we are. So you can leave this as is. I don't want mine this loud and I don't want it to fill the whole canvas. So I'm going to create a clipping mask. We'll leave our sunburst layer on top. Let me rename this. And let's create a circle with no stroke. I think in this general area would be nice. We want our circle beneath the sunburst, and the sunburst creates the clipping mask. So this is now what I have, and I am just going to adjust the opacity and the blend mode if I would like. I kind of do like color burn. We'll see, but let's keep it pushing before we get stuck. So I think now that we have the big main focal point here, besides of course our copy, because of course people need the information, what is this event? I'm going to go ahead and add that next, and I'm going to add that next because having that big copy on here will help me figure out where everything else on the composition is going to go. So let's work on our title. After taking a look at the fonts that I went through earlier, I decided to go with RoboTag. I feel like it wasn't too on the nose, but still fit the theme. Another thing that I did notice was underlining under certain text, potentially the most important text. So I am going to utilize that here as well. I am going to do that with a rectangle shape so that they're just easier for me to pick up and place around if I want to add some anywhere else. We'll do one for midnight and one for rodeo as well. Cool, and of course we gotta get her from up under there. So let's just keep our photos over all of the copy. Okay, cool, so I went ahead and added more copy to our poster. For more information, of course, we have Roadshow Theater. Our title is Midnight Rodeo, Little Shadow in the Back. And at the bottom, we have a limited run. Don't miss the ride. Now, all we really have to do is add in the tour information. Where are we going? What days are we stopping? And the extras, you know, the pizzazz, the other elements. So I think I'm going to bring in the rest of our photos. Let's pull them on top of our key art. And I think for these photos here, instead of just cutting all of them out, I think that might be a little too like flat for this poster. If you notice on some examples of this design style, you'll see photos are placed in different styles, different shapes. Some are cut out, some are in circles, some are in odd shapes. Whatever it is, I think we can kind of play with that here and experiment a bit with that. Don't want to go too crazy, but we can get a couple circles in here at least. And we will, of course, apply the same color overlay as our original photos. So I think for this one, we'll go ahead and place this into a circle. I'm going to mask this with our elliptical marquee. And I want to make sure I get the context of the photo. We have to include the money, of course. So we added that, and with our photo selected, we'll mask. Now that we have our circle here, we will resize it, place it where we see fit. I think I want this one down here. It could be a little bit smaller. We'll see how this all fits on here. And of course, we're going to copy the layer styles from our key art so that we do have that color overlay on there. Perfect. It does feel a little flat, so I'm going to add a stroke to the outside of our circle. That is way too big. Let's make this a little bit smaller, but just noticeable enough. And we would like to actually make it the same color as our background so that it seems like it's kind of cut out from the other photos that we've already placed on the poster. Maybe just a bit smaller. That's cool. Cool. Let's stay right there. Who else do we have? This guy here. We're just going to cut him out. We're just going to cut him out. I wouldn't know what else to do with you. I'm going to have him hang out down here again with our color overlay. He looks great. He looks great. He probably should have been the star of the show, if you ask me. And I don't think I need this whole photo, so we will just do a rectangle, a small rectangle around these two, and we'll mask those. Same with the color overlay, and we'll place them off to the side. Now you can see our bounding box is much larger than the image that we've created. I like to crop when I'm satisfied. This just is non-committal. Okay, and now we need some info on our stops on the tour. I think this is where we will bring or start to bring some of our red in. I'm going to keep up with the basic shapes here, and we definitely would like this to be red and loud. And I'm just going to fill a few of these shapes in with the city that we are going to and the date that we are stopping. So for this one, it'll be LA. For the color of this type, I will have it match the background, almost like it's giving a knockout type of effect. And let's include a date here. Let's do August 28. We can't see it. August 28th. And just to bring some balance into the city and the date, I am going to continue with the underlining motif on the dates throughout the poster. I like that style. What do we think? Should we add the rest? So all of our tour info is here. I'd say the bulk of our copy is already on here. So now we can start adding our extras and we know where they can fit. We definitely have to add stars. That is a requirement. It just is. I don't make the rules. I'm going to grab our polygon tool and create our 5-point shape. And I'm going to bring the star ratio down to 50% to create a perfect star. And of course, our stars should be the same red that we just used to make them stand out. I am just going to place these where I see fit throughout the poster. I do want to add three nights only onto this poster, and I do kind of want to add a second pop of color. Might be a bad idea, could be doing too much, but I have to try it. I have to. Just a basic rectangle back here, or a square rather, and I think I want it to be yellow. And let's move our rectangle back behind the photos, correct. And now we have some clear space right here to add our three nights only text. That looks great. So I'm gonna clean up something, slightly rearrange, but we do want to add in our texture. We can't forget. So I brought in both a grunge texture and a paper texture. The grunge texture is more so to affect the photos themselves and the elements on the poster to make them look a little more faded and old and worn. And then the paper texture is to make the overall paper look like paper, of course. So I'm going to start with the grunge texture. I'm going to adjust my blend mode. I want to do lighter color. Definitely looks faded, a little too much, so let's bring our opacity down. And then to add the paper texture on top of that, we are going to use Multiply, and we're definitely gonna bring this all the way down. And I think we have landed somewhere, so there you have it. We have created our own poster for the Midnight Rodeo Tour, stopping in three cities, three nights only, in our modern Western poster aesthetic. If you did get some inspo to try this out for yourself and maybe do it better, please let us know what other assets or elements you might include to match the style that we went with today, and I will see you later.